Hey, it's Mikey. Let's talk about Black Ops 3 and how to get a couple of calling cards you guys have been requesting. If there's any particular calling card you want, leave a comment below. You can tweet me, Facebook me. Right now, we're going to talk about how to get the nuked out. That is 30 kills in free-for-all without using score streaks to get your kills. The nuclear killer, 30 kills without dying. And we might as well throw this one into the brutal killer. 25 kills without dying. So obviously the game mode is gonna be free for all. You should just go for these all at once. And I'm gonna talk about my top 5 tips how to get a nuke. Let's get into it. So the first tip is your sound. Here is my sound settings. First thing you wanna do is disable that music. You want to hear everything. Footsteps, people climbing, people jumping, wall running, throwing equipment. You need to hear it all. And music is just gonna kind of take away from that. The other thing for the audio preset, I suggest Super Crunch. This allows you to hear the dead silence users a little bit better, and we're gonna get more into the sound as we get into this video here. People wanna know my settings. Now, just because I use look sensitivity horizontal on 6 and the vertical on 6 doesn't mean you have to. You use what's comfortable for you. And the only reason why I'm showing you this is just because people asked last time. So I'm gonna show you, and I play around with it a lot. Sometimes I have it on an 8. Other times I'm not doing so great. I put on a 4 or a 5. If you watch pro players, you know they use like 3 or 4. So it's really all about you, but this is just for your information. I happen to have it on 6 when I got this gameplay. Next thing is your network. You want to have it on OpenNet. Allows you to find a game with a good connection. If you don't know how to do OpenNet, you can Google it, or I will have a link down below. Number 2 tip, our setup and our streaks. Setup, the gun is really whatever happens to be kind of good at the time. For me, I like the VMP because it's consistent, at least when I'm recording this video. I like the suppressor because it allows us not to grab too much attention. The guy that you're gonna be in a gunfight with, he's already gonna bring that attention, okay? So we don't need any more. So suppressor is good. The grip is gonna help with the recoil because the VMP does have a little bit of recoil and it helps for those long range shots. And the extended mag is a must on no matter what it is you use. It could save you for many reasons. One, if you encounter 2 or 3 enemies, extended clip is gonna help you there. If you have a bad aim, if you're panicky, extended mag allows you to be really sloppy and you can literally spray and pray. Okay, extended mag, it saved me many, many times, and not just for going for a nuke. The trip mine. Now the trip mine, it really isn't there so much for kills. You can either use the trip mine or you can use the shock charge. It's really a preference. The trip mine, maybe out of 10 that you throw, maybe you'll get 1 kill. Really, it's there for audio cues. If someone happens to trip it up, you can hear it. Sometimes people shoot them and destroy them, and when they shoot them, you can hear them, and that gives away their position. And as a bonus, hey, maybe you'll get a kill, okay? This thing really doesn't get many kills, but it's there just to really, it's sort of like a proximity alarm in a way, okay? You can throw down 2 of them if you have scavenger on, or if you decide to use the shock charges, you can actually throw down 3 of those, okay? And I mentioned scavenger, that is our only perk 2 that we've got. And the reason for that is, well, 1, you don't wanna switch weapons. You wanna keep what you're comfortable with, and we want unlimited trip mines. We want the sound horse setup. You gotta have awareness to hear the dead silence users. And remember, you gotta have it on Super Crunch for your presets. And obviously dead silence, because you don't wanna be stomping around. I know you're thinking, what about tactical mask? Well, you're actually gonna be moving around and stuff. Okay, that's, you'll see when I break down the gameplay. For our specialist, I like combat focus because that's what's gonna allow us to get our hater faster. We need that so badly to know where people are looking, where they're coming from. It's just, I mean, it's a no-brainer. You want to get that hater as soon as you can. Okay, speaking of hater, let's get into our streaks. UAV, hater, and the power core. And the power core, I'm gonna get into how I use that because it may not be how you think. All right, so we spawn in here, and this is not where I want to be. You want to limit your area to 2 major choke points, okay? First off, these extended mags, look at that. It just helped me right there because, as I said, it helps when you have not the best aim. Okay, maybe you're having a bad gunfight. It's you're sort of sloppy for whatever reason. Right there, extended mags already helped me out. Now, I'm already making my way to a part of the map that I like. As I said, we want to limit the traffic to two major areas. You don't want to be shot from the side, and I'm already setting down trip mines just as those, as proximity alarms, if you will. Okay, I don't want to sprint around too mindlessly, and as you can see, you get two trip mines there. The other thing is, what I learned is if you see people off in a distance, don't chase them. Do not chase them. Do not get in that trance, because what you're doing is you're giving up your back. Okay, you want to, I've decided this is my zone. I'm going to control this area. There's two major points. This is the third right here, this window. And it is kind of dangerous because I can be shot from that house. But for the most part, people aren't going to climb through there. There is this area here, but thankfully to our sound setup that we've done, I can hear people if they're wall running, if they're stomping on the dirt, we can get to them and they can't shoot us from the side. So basically I've limited from that door and this other door for the most part. And you see where I'm aiming, how I aim in front of the door a little bit. I mean, that's just basic Call of Duty, that, you know, due to your reaction time, due to lag, you want to pre-aim ahead of where the enemy is going to be. By the time your eyeballs react, by the time you could send the message from your brain to your hands. And we're using combat focus so that way we can get our hater, and we've got it now. And I'm just constantly setting down these mines. Okay, now we can be a little more gutsy because the hater's up, and I could just, you know, I'm still being careful. Still being careful, but I can run around a little more free. And there's extended mags helping me out. I do not have the best aim. Sometimes you get a little nervous here. And speaking of getting nervous, there's a parkour. Speaking of getting nervous, number one tip, I'd say, another good tip, maybe not number one, do not look at your score. Don't look at it. It's not gonna help you. All it's gonna do is make you nervous. Just focus on the guy in front of you, what you're shooting at. Do not look at your score. When I got this, I was like, what? I got it? That was the best thing, because if you're looking at your score, all it's going to do is make your palms sweaty. Okay, it's going to make you all nervous and you're going to panic. Do not look at it. I mean, if I could, I'd put like a sticker over it or something. We have our power core, but I'm not using it. Why? Well, there really isn't any point. The power core makes some noise, has that hum. They can kind of distract you, and really it's in the rare moment someone gets a streak, stealth bomb or rolling thunder, a UAV, something like that. That's the power core is sort of like your ace in the hole, right? Ace up your sleeve. That's when you want to use it. You have to decide when you want to use it. And when you do use it, you'll see I will put it somewhere where it can be distracting, in front of a doorway, out in the open. So that way the enemy is tempted to shoot at it, to destroy it. So it acts as like a sort of like a bait, if you will. And you can see I'm constantly moving. I'm not camping in a corner. And I'm about to put the EMP very, very soon. That guy jumping around, I like to pick a part of the map that sort of limits someone's vertical movement. Okay, whatever map you pick to get your MOBOND, your nuclear, you don't want them doing that halo jumping and all that stuff. You want to make them stand your level so they have to shoot at you. So now these guys are getting pretty aggressive. This guy right there that I just killed, he's gonna start coming at me later with some rocket launchers. And I can hear two people. That's why I'm going bonkers right now. I'm like, where is he? There's a guy over here. There's that rocket guy. He was mad. And we'll see his point of view later on. He was starting to get pretty pissed off. There's a power core. I called that in finally because we're getting close to getting another power core. That guy almost killed me. That was the closest he got right there. And so the power core is right there by the door. So that way it's very tempting for someone to shoot at it. There's the extended mags coming into work again. This guy's attacking it. Go ahead, dude. I will kill you while you're shooting that. And again, I'm already at the 25 streak. This is around the point you'll get your Buddha medal. Hater, just look at how the haters makes it so easy. And being patient, pre-aiming, even though the hater it tells you where they're at, it's not 100%. There's still a little bit of lag. Got our hater here, or our EMP Sorry, and I'm just... There's a hostile UAV. Let's get rid of that. Put it in the window. Maybe someone will want to shoot it from there. I don't know. And we're about ready to call in combat focus to get our next streak. We're getting really close, and I had no clue that I was this close. I was not looking at my scoreboard. And what happens here? I think I see some guy out here. See, we're just getting in this pattern, move back and forth. And look at my UAV. I see that guy there. What's he doing? He's pre-aiming. And he was actually, we'll see, I'll insert a clip from his point of view. He was mad and he was just destined to kill me. The other thing is luck. There's so much luck involved in this challenge. It's ridiculous. And the sooner you accept that there's luck involved, it's not going to make everything better, but it'll help you deal with the challenge a little bit more. The other thing is you're going to be failing a lot, and I'll just put the information out there that if you leave as soon as you see match bonus, it won't count as a loss. I mean, you're more than welcome to leave the game after one death. You can do that if you want, but if you're willing to just speed things up, get into the next match as soon as possible, you can leave as soon as match bonus pops up on the screen, and that won't count as a loss. Okay, so that's four tips, right? And now, if you watch this far, I'm gonna give you one of the best tips. And this is gonna be our little secret. And we actually did this in Black Ops 2. The final tip, number five, is delete your DLC. Okay, whatever DLC is out there at the time, whatever that is not free, all the map packs, whatever it is, delete them, because you're gonna go up against much more casual players. It's all the hardcore fans that have Nuketown installed and the map packs and things like that. Now, if you're watching this in the future, Nuketown is probably free. Okay, so you can keep Nuketown, but all the other map packs, get rid of them, because you're gonna have like just people who just randomly play, they don't care, and that is how you get to go up against lower levels. Okay, and that's what I did. Deleted. In this case, I deleted Nuketown. I did it last year for Black, or no, I'm sorry, 3 years ago for Black Ops 2. Delete all my map packs, and you go against lower levels, and they're just not as sweaty. But you will get other people in there who are doing the same thing that you're doing. So just be aware of that. You will go up against 2KD, 3KD players every now and then. But at least if you delete your DLC, you have a higher chance of going up against lower levels, all right? So I hope that helps you out. If there's a particular calling card you need help with, just leave a comment below, tweet me, Facebook me, whatever, and I will get to work on that. By the way, if you could take 3 seconds to rate the video, I'd really appreciate it. It does help the channel grow. If you wanna come out to open lobbies, participate in contests for updates, things like that, follow me on Twitter, Facebook, links down below. All right, so on the left side there, we have more Call of Duty tips, tricks, info, updates. It's a playlist. I keep that updated for you. You can click on the screen or links down below. And on the right side, guys, I gotta give a big shout out to my sponsor, Ting. Ting is the pay what you actually use cell phone service. It's no BS fees, 4G service, new and used phones, and I've been using them for over a year before they even sponsored me. So I average about $20 a month on my iPhone. If you want to save hundreds of dollars a year, visit mikey.ting.com and they will hook you up with $25 credit that you can use on the service or a new or used phone. So if you want, you can use the calculator on their site to see how much your bill would be. That's mikey.ting.com. You can click on the screen or links down below.